I like the way Pierce Turner sings. He walks on the tabletops and dances between the ashtrays and the glasses. As the women peek up the leg of his trousers, he lets on not to notice. He's lived in New York now since he was only a chap, and he's totally unaffected by it, but the model is still dripping off him. He comes home often for the weekend, jumps off the 747 for Wexford, and he don't even look back for the leg. For he do hit the ground running, straight away sending in a high ball to Nicky Rackard or Tony Dorden or Super Sub, depending upon the mood he's in. I played in the Opera House in Wexford one night and a bat went mad. It's a dangerous name to give four walls and a roof. Opera House. It probably needs a bit of bingo to knock the edges off it. What is it with people who go to opera? Why all the fur coats and tuxedos and jewellery? What is it? We went to hear Pavarotti in the RDS and it was a right fucking gallery. Talk about fur coats and no knickers, be Jesus. Corporate boxes, business boxes, dirty boxes, smelly boxes. Your man disappeared for a feed after every song. He took more bows, be Jesus. Every song was treated like a complete concert. Such palaver. And the conductor did a fair bit of shaping too. I was exhausted watching the two of them. Now don't get me wrong. Pavarotti has an incredible voice and is truly a wonderful artist. But a few more songs and a few less exits and entrances would have suited this listener. My only experience of ballet was Swan Lake in San Francisco, one of the Russian companies. I couldn't keep my eyes open. I left at the interval and went back to my hotel, and then I couldn't sleep a wink. It's a mad fucking city, that. I met a coke dealer there. He sold me great gear for half nothing and then insisted that we constantly chop from his stash. It was the purest, which is it nearly broke me heart. We drove across the bridge to do two shows in Sausalito, travelled with a doctor and a novelist in a sweet car. We got to the gig in the little club with lots and lots of local wine and weed and more coke, then back across the bay to the doctor's house. Madness, fucking madness. The behaviour was building towards the heart attack. Eventually got to bed at 11 o'clock the next morning with two shows to do that night at the Great American Music Hall. I woke up in the early afternoon in the complete horrors. Mild DTs coupled with a coke hangover, body and brain under heavy pressure. I had no idea how I was going to do a show, never mind two shows. I got to the venue and began trying to nurture the body, mind and nervous system back into a shape. A couple of gin and tonics, a Valium, then a few lines, and as the show approached, a large gin and tonic and a couple of more lines. The first show was very difficult. There was lots of fla cowboys and fla cowgirls and a few old Newbridge expats who couldn't get in. Both houses were sold out, but the boys broke the stage door down and had to be exited by the crowd control engineers. The second show was mellow and, in fact, ended up as quite a good show.